Hello and welcome to this special politically correct edition of Extreme Prejudice. I'm your host, James Smith, and although I am male, I just want to assure our viewers this network has a strict equal opportunity employment policy, and of course, I am gay. So let's meet our contestants now. Barbara is a 53-year-old bike-riding vegan from Adelaide. She likes organic red wine, films she doesn't understand, and she's a swinging voter. So, Barbara, you're voting for both Labor and Liberal.
The Democrats and Greens, James.
Of course. Terry is a 47-year-old volunteer art gallery guide from Sydney's eastern suburbs. She's married to an extremely rich barrister, though, of course, she does feel very guilty about it. And Steve is a straight white man from a working-class suburb in Melbourne. He's 35, has a job, has not been abused as a child, and has no disabilities. All right, let's get started. But just before we do, I'd like to take a moment to acknowledge that the traditional owners of this land are, of course, the Wurundjeri people. Okay, time to kick off now with our Mad Minute. Barbara?
Sorry, James. Shouldn't that be psychiatrically challenged minute?
Correct. Okay, complete this phrase. All men are... Barbara.
Bastards.
Unless they're...
Gay men.
Correct. Okay, anyone accused of a sexual offence should be... Terry.
Thrown in jail forever without a trial.
Unless, of course, they're accused of committing a sexual offence while serving on the board of ATSIC, in which case they were...
Framed.
Correct. Liberal MP Tony Abbott was roundly criticised by women's groups for allegedly abandoning an illegitimate child. But when Mark Latham called a female journalist a skanky hoe, no one said anything. Why was that? Terry?
Because Latham's in the Labor Party.
Correct! What is the technical term for the rights that fathers have in the family court? That was, of course, a trick question. Fathers have no rights in the family court. If everyone agrees Australia should become a republic, why did over 60% of Australians reject the idea of a republic at a recent referendum? Steve?
Because maybe, you know, everyone doesn't want Australia to become a republic?
All right, just stop the clock. You give one more answer like that, mate, and you're out, okay? Ladies, why did 60% of Australians reject a republic?
I find that question offensive.
Close, Terry.
Because ordinary Australians are too stupid to know what's good for them and shouldn't have been allowed to vote in the first place?
Correct. Okay, Yothu Yindi are what? Steve.
A pop band.
Barbara.
A wonderfully talented Indigenous supergroup who make me proud to live in this diverse and multicultural society.
Correct. Supplementary question. Name one person you know who has ever bought a Yothu Yindi album. Okay, final question for 50 points. Who am I? I was born in Queensland in 1970 and overcame a poor upbringing to become one of Australia's best-known Aboriginal dancers. Steve?
Patrick Theaday.
Patrick Theaday is correct!
My sister's married to a dancer who's black. Sorry, a person of colour. Person of colour.
And so at the end of our game, it's Steve who's come from behind to take the win with 30 points. Steve, congratulations. You must be delighted.
Yeah, I am. Thanks, James. I really didn't expect to win.
Well, you haven't, because now we need to apply this show's affirmative action policy to your points and redistribute them to Barbara and Terry, making them the winners and you the loser. We'll see you next time on Extreme Prejudice, Politically Correct Edition.